chapter on regarding Surat Al-Maidah. Tariq bin Shihab said, a man among the Jews said to Umar bin al-Khattab, O Commander of the Believers, if we were the ones unto whom this ayah was revealed, this day I have perfected your religion for you, completed my favor upon you, and have chosen for you Islam as your religion. Then we would have taken that day as a day of celebration. So Umar bin al-Khattab said to him, Indeed, I do know which day this ayah was revealed upon. It was revealed on the day of Arafah, on Friday. This hadith is graded sahih, or authentic. Footnote. The verse, This day I have perfected your religion for you, completed my favor upon you, and have chosen for you Islam as your religion, is from Surat Al-Ma'idah, chapter 5, verse 3. Comments. This ayah, because it was revealed on the day of Arafah and on a Friday, and both these days are like the days of Eid for the Muslims, so the Muslims, on their own behalf, are not allowed to celebrate any day as Eid, because their Eid are appointed by Allah. It is you people who make self-made additions to their religion, and you appoint the days of celebration and festivals according to your own desires. Unfortunately, some Muslims have also introduced and added an Eid. Ammar bin Abi Ammar said, Ibn Abbas recited, This day, I have perfected your religion for you, completed my favor upon you, and have chosen for you Islam as your religion. And a Jew was with him who said, If this ayah was revealed to us, then we would have taken that day as a day of celebration. So Ibn Abbas said, Indeed, it was revealed on two Eids, on Friday and on the day of Arafah. This hadith is graded sahih, or authentic. Footnote. The verse, This day, I have perfected your religion for you, completed my favor upon you, and have chosen for you Islam as your religion, is from Surat Al-Ma'idah, chapter 5, verse 3. Abu Huraira said, The Messenger of Allah, peace be upon him, said, Ar-Rahman's hand is full. He spends without any decrease, night and day. He said, Do you not see how much he has spent since he created the heavens and the earth? Yet he has not decreased what is in his hand, and his throne is over the water. And in his other hand is the mizan, scale, which he raises and lowers. This hadith is graded sahih, or authentic. Comments. The Imma said with respect to this hadith, it will be believed exactly as it was told. Its explanation and commentary will not be assumed, nor should one fall victim to doubt and whims. Many of the Imma said the same thing. Sufyan al-Thawri, Malik bin Anas, Ibn Uyayna, and Ibn al-Mubarak also said the same. The ayah and the hadith that speak about the names and attributes of Allah are to be reported and believed truly and exactly without the slightest metaphorical explanation, and one must not say anything about the condition, assumed reality, and try to explain their nature. Aisha said, The Prophet, peace be upon him, was being guarded until this ayah was revealed. Allah will protect you from mankind. So the Messenger of Allah, peace be upon him, struck his head out from the room and said, O you people, go away, for Allah shall protect me. This hadith is graded gharib, or strange. Muslim bin Ibrahim narrated it similar with this chain. Some of them reported this hadith from Al-Jurayri, from Abdullah ibn Shaqiq, who said, The Prophet, peace be upon him, was being guarded, and they did not mention from Aisha in it. This hadith is graded hasan, or good. Comments. In the city of Al-Madinah, the Jews, in alliance with the hypocrites, used to always be busy in conspiring against the Prophet, peace be upon him, and the Muslims. Therefore, the noble companions would guard and keep watch for the Prophet, peace be upon him. The Prophet, peace be upon him, forbade the guards after this ayah was revealed. Abdullah ibn Mas'ud narrated, The Messenger of Allah, peace be upon him, said, When the children of Israel fell into disobedience, their scholars forbade them from it. But they did not stop, so they sat with them in their gatherings, and participated in eating and drinking with them. So Allah pitied their hearts against each other, and cursed them upon the tongue of Dawood and Isa ibn Maryam. That was because they disobeyed and were ever transgressing. He said, The Messenger of Allah, peace be upon him, sat up after he had been reclining, And he said, No, by the one in whose hand is my soul, not until you incline them to the truth. Abdullah bin Abdul Rahman said, Yazid said, Sufyan al-Thawri would not say in it. From Abdullah, This hadith is graded da'if or weak. Comments. This hadith guides that the evildoers should be enjoined of doing good, with power, authority, and enthusiasm, and they should be prevented from doing bad things. Those who do not abandon committing evil doings, they should not be collaborated with, nor should their initiatives be accepted and Abu Ubaidah said, The Messenger of Allah, peace be upon him, said, When the children of Israel fell into decline, a man among them would see his brother committing a sin, and prohibit him from it. The next day, what he saw him doing would not prevent him from eating with him, drinking with him, and associating with him. So Allah pitied their hearts against each other, and He revealed about them in the Qur'an. He said, Those among the children of Israel who disbelieved were cursed by the tongue of Dawood and Isa, son of Maryam. That was because they disobeyed and were ever transgressing. And he recited until he reached, And had they believed in Allah and in the Prophet, and in what has been revealed to him, never would they have taken them as friends. But many of them are rebellious. He said, And Allah's Prophet, peace be upon him, was reclining, so he sat up and said, No, not until you take the hand of the wrongdoer and incline him toward the truth. This hadith is graded da'if, or weak. Footnote, the verses, Those among the children of Israel who disbelieved were cursed by the tongue of Dawood and Isa, son of Maryam. That was because they disobeyed and were ever transgressing. Until, and had they believed in Allah and in the Prophet, and in what has been revealed to him, never would they have taken them as friends. But many of them are rebellious. Are from Surat Al-Maidah, chapter 5, verse 78 to 81. Comments. Every prophet from Dawood up to Isa, Jesus, cursed the people of Israel because of their evil doings and offenses. In the lifetime of the Prophet, peace be upon him, these people had very strong relations and alliances with the disbelievers of Mecca. Even they would consider the disbelievers more guided than the Muslims. Amr bin Shurabil, Abu Maysara, narrated from Umar bin al-Khattab that he said, O Allah, make the verdict concerning Khamr sufficiently clear for us. So the ayah, in al-Baqarah was revealed. They ask you concerning Khamr and gambling. Say, in them is a great sin. So Umar was called, and it was recited to him. So he said, O Allah, make the verdict concerning Khamr sufficiently clear for us. So the ayah, in An-Nisa was revealed. O you who believe, approach not a salah while you are in a drunken state. So Umar was called, and it was recited to him. So he said, O Allah, make the verdict clear for us. So the ayah, in Al-Ma'idah, was revealed. Shaitan only wants to excite enmity and hatred between you with khamr and gambling, up to his saying, So will you not then abstain? So Umar was called, and it was recited to him. So he said, We abstained, we abstained. This hadith is graded da'if, or weak. Footnotes. 1. The verse, They ask you concerning khamr and gambling, say in them is a great sin, is from Surat al-Baqarah, chapter 2, verse 219. 2. The verse, O you who believe, approach not a salah while you are in a drunken state, is from Surat al-Nisa, chapter 4, verse 43. 3. The verse, Shaitan only wants to excite enmity and hatred between you with khamr and gambling, up to his saying, so will you not then abstain, is from Surat al-Ma'idah, chapter 5, verse 91. Abu Maysara narrated from Umar bin al-Khattab, who said, O Allah, make the verdict concerning khamr sufficiently clear for us. This hadith is graded da'if, or weak. Comments. This hadith tells us that the prohibition of intoxicants was revealed gradually. It has been declared clearly in Surat al-Ma'idah that the ill effects and evil consequences of intoxicants and gambling have become clear to you at various occasions, incidents, and from various aspects. Would you still not avoid those? Is there still any shadow of doubt remaining? Al-Bara said, A man among the companions of the Prophet, peace be upon him, died before khamr had been made unlawful. So when khamr was made unlawful, some men said, How about our companions who died while drinking khamr? So the following was revealed. Those who believe and do righteous good deeds, there is no sin on them for what they ate, if they have taqwa and perform good. This hadith is graded sahih or authentic. Footnote. The verse, those who believe and do righteous good deeds, there is no sin on them for what they ate, if they have taqwa and perform good, is from Surat Al-Maidah, chapter 5, verse 93. Comments. The clear indications towards the prohibition of intoxicants have already been made before the revelation of the verses of Surat Al-Maidah. Despite that, the people kept drinking, so the concerns regarding them rose in their hearts about what would happen to them. It was answered, as this rule was revealed gradually. Therefore, Allah would not hold accountable such people who acted according to the granted permission. Al-Bara bin Azib said, some people among the companions of the Prophet, peace be upon him, died while they had been drinking khamr. So when it was revealed that it was unlawful, some people among the companions of the Messenger of Allah, peace be upon him, said, how about our companions who died while they were drinking it? So the following ayah was revealed. Those who believe and do righteous good deeds, there is no sin on them for what they ate. This hadith is graded sahih or authentic. Footnote. The verse, those who believe and do righteous good deeds, there is no sin on them for what they ate, is from Surat Al-Ma'idah, chapter 5, verse 93. It was narrated that Ibn Abbas said, they, the companions, said, O Messenger of Allah, how do you hold those who died while they were drinking khamr, considering that the prohibition of intoxicants is now revealed? So, the following ayah was revealed. Those who believe and do righteous good deeds, there is no sin on them for what they ate in the past, if they fear Allah and believe and do righteous good deeds. This hadith is graded hasan, or good. Abdullah said, when the following was revealed, those who believe and do righteous good deeds, there is no sin on them for what they ate, if they have taqwa and perform good. The Messenger of Allah, peace be upon him, said to me, you are among them. This hadith is graded hasan, or good. Footnote. The verse, those who believe and do righteous good deeds, there is no sin on them for what they ate, if they have taqwa and perform good, is from Surat Al-Ma'idah, chapter 5, verse 93. Comments. Taqwa, piety, has been mentioned 3 times in this particular verse. First time, it was mentioned with faith and righteous deeds. The second time, along with faith. And the third time, along with doing good. Here, the mention of taqwa 3 times, i.e., care for the restrictions and abiding by the rules of Allah, has been made according to the gradual stages of the prohibition of intoxicants. The mention of faith and righteous deeds, along with taqwa, expresses that the avoidance from anything will not be taken into consideration by Allah until this avoidance is accompanied with faith and righteous deeds. Ikrimah narrated from Ibn Abbas, a man came to the Prophet, peace be upon him, and said, O Messenger of Allah, when I consume meat and I get around women, my desires get the best of me. So I made meat unlawful for myself. So Allah revealed, O you who believe, make not unlawful the good things which Allah has made lawful to you, and transgress not. Verily, Allah does not like the transgressors, and eat of the things which Allah has provided for you, lawful and good. This hadith is graded sahih, or authentic. Footnote. The verses, O you who believe, make not unlawful the good things which Allah has made lawful to you, and transgress not. Verily, Allah does not like the transgressors, and eat of the things which Allah has provided for you, lawful and good, are from Surat Al-Ma'idah, chapter 5, verse 87 to 88. Comments. These verses teach us a very fundamental principle. Anything that Allah has declared lawful, to then make it unlawful is an illegal act, as is making lawful that which Allah has prohibited. Making things unlawful is that a person declares something unlawful for himself or for others. He does so considering it as a requirement by the religion or a commandment of Allah. Abu al-Bukhtari narrated from Ali, who said, when the following was revealed, and Hajj to the house is a duty that mankind owes to Allah for those who are able to undertake the journey. They said, O Messenger of Allah, every year? But he was silent. So they said, O Messenger of Allah, every year? He said, no. If I were to say yes, then it would be required. And Allah, mighty and sublime is He, revealed, O you who believe, ask not about things which, if made plain to you, may cause you trouble. This hadith is graded da'if, or weak. Footnotes. 1. The verse, and Hajj to the house is a duty that mankind owes to Allah for those who are able to undertake the journey, is from Surat Al-Imran, chapter 3, verse 97. 2. The verse, O you who believe, ask not about things which, if made plain to you, may cause you trouble, is from Surat Al-Maidah, chapter 5, verse 101. There are authentic chains for it with Muslim and others. See hadith number 814, which preceded. Comments. The meaning of this ayah is that a question should be asked carefully and mindfully. A question should be asked for the true objective of benefiting everybody and to increase the knowledge of the Sharia. Making things more restricted and causing hardships by asking unnecessary questions is incorrect. Anas bin Malik narrated that a man said,
O Messenger of Allah, who is my father? He said, Your father is so-and-so. He said, So the following was revealed. O you who believe, ask not about things which, if made plain to you, may cause you trouble. This hadith is graded sahih, or authentic. Footnote. The verse, O you who believe, ask not about things which, if made plain to you, may cause you trouble, is from Surat Al-Ma'idah, chapter 5, verse 101. Comments. The Prophet's, peace be upon him's, duty is to convey the teachings of religion and the Sharia, knowledge about the people's family lineage, or to tell them who is whose father, is out of the Prophet's, peace be upon him's, duty and mission. Therefore, it is an unreasonable question. Abu Bakr as-Siddiq said, O you people, you recite this ayah. Take care of yourselves. If you follow the guidance, no harm shall come to you from those who are astray. I indeed heard the Messenger of Allah, peace be upon him, saying, When the people see the wrongdoer, and they do not stop him from doing wrong, then it is soon that Allah shall envelope you in a punishment from him. This hadith is graded sahih, or authentic. Footnotes. 1. The verse, Take care of yourselves. If you follow the guidance, no harm shall come to you from those who are astray, is from Surat Al-Ma'idah, chapter 5, verse 105. 2. This preceded under hadith number 2168. Comments. The aim of Abu Bakr, may Allah be pleased with him, in pointing out this ayah, guides that the people who are committing sins and wrongdoing, you keep telling them to do good and preventing them from evil. If they do not listen, they will harm themselves. They will not harm you at all. And eventually, they will face the consequences of their wrongdoing. It never causes harm to those who are guided to the right path.
Abu Umayyah al-Sha'bani said, I went to Abu Thalaba al-Kushani and said to him, How do you deal with this ayah? He said, Which ayah? I said, Allah saying, Take care of yourselves. If you follow the guidance, no harm shall come to you. He said, Well, by Allah, I asked one well informed about it. I asked the Messenger of Allah, peace be upon him, about it. So, he said, Rather, comply with and order the good, and stay away from and prohibit the evil, until you see avarice obeyed, desires followed, and the world preferred. And everyone with an opinion is amazed with his view. Then you should be worried about yourself in particular, and worry of the common folk. Ahead of you are the days in which patience is like holding on to an ember. For the doer of righteous deeds, during them, is like of the reward of 50 of those who do the like of what you do. Abdullah bin al-Mubarak said, It was added for me, by other than Utbah, that it was said, O Messenger of Allah, the reward of 50 men among us or among them? He said, No, rather the reward of 50 men among you. This hadith is graded sahih, or authentic. Footnote. The verse, Take care of yourselves. If you follow the guidance, no harm shall come to you, is from Surat Al-Ma'idah, chapter 5, verse 105. Comments. The result of doing, obeying, and caring for the good is enjoining good.
and the result of avoiding evil is the prevention of evil. But when the covetousness of wealth prevail upon the people, they become slaves of worldly benefits due to the consequences of following the whims and desires. The people are overwhelmed by the pride of their personal views and by the illusion of their self-liking, and they do not care for listening to others. Then there is no need for being distressed by worrying about them.
Ibn Abbas narrated from Tamim al-Dari regarding this ayah, O you who believe, when death approaches any of you, then take the testimony. He said, the people are innocent of it, other than myself and Adi bin Badda. We were Christians who used to frequent Asham before Islam. They went to Asham for their business, and they were approached by a freed slave of Banu Sahm, who was called Budail bin Abi Maryam, with some trade. He had a bowl they wanted made of silver, but he wanted a great deal for it. Then he became ill, and willed it to them, and he commissioned them to deliver what was left to his family. Tamim said, when he died, we took that bowl and we sold it for 1,000 dirham. Then Adi bin Badda and I divided it. When we went to his family to give them what was with us, they searched for the bowl and asked us about it. We said, he did not leave behind other than this, nor did he give us other than this. Tamim said, when I accepted Islam, after the Messenger of Allah, peace be upon him, had arrived in Al-Medina, I felt guilty about that. So I went to his family and informed them about what had happened. I gave them 50,000 dirham and told them that my companion had the same. They took him to the Messenger of Allah, peace be upon him, but he asked them for their proof, which they did not have. So he ordered them to have him to take an oath in accordance with whatever the people of his religion revered. So he took the oath. Then Allah revealed, O you who believe, when death approaches any of you, then take the testimony, up to his saying, or else they would fear the oaths will be admitted after their oaths. So Amr bin al-As and another man stood to take an oath, and the 50,000 dirham was taken from Adi bin Badda. This hadith is graded mawdu', or fabricated. Footnote, the verse, O you who believe, when death approaches any of you, then take the testimony, up to his saying, or else they would fear the oaths will be admitted after their oaths, is from Surat al-Ma'idah, Chapter 5, Verse 106. Comments. The aim of this ayah is that if a Muslim is on the verge of death, and he is in need of making a will regarding his property and belongings, for this he will appoint two reliable and trustworthy witnesses from among the Muslims. And in case of him being on a journey, if two Muslim witnesses are not available due to this crucial condition, he may appoint two non-Muslim witnesses. Ibn Abbas said, a man from Banu Sahm went out with Tamim al-Dari and Adi bin Badda. The Sahmi man died in a land in which there were no Muslims. When they arrived with what he left behind, they searched for a bowl made of silver which was inlaid with gold. The Messenger of Allah, peace be upon him, had the two of them take an oath. Then they found the bowl in Mecca, and the person said, we purchased it from Tamim and Adi. So, two men among the relatives of the Sahmi man stood to take an oath by Allah that they, his family, had more right to it than them. He said, so it was about them that the following was revealed. O you who believe, when death approaches any of you, then take the testimony. This hadith is graded sahih, or authentic. Footnote, the verse, O you who believe, when death approaches any of you, then take the testimony, is from Surat al-Ma'idah, Chapter 5, Verse 106. Comments. This man from the Sahmi tribe made a list of things and put them in his property. He entrusted his property to his Christian companions and requested them to hand it over to his heirs. The Christian companions hid a silver bowl away from the property, while the bowl was still in the list of the property. Ammar bin Yasir said, the Messenger of Allah, peace be upon him, said, the Ma'idah was sent down from the heavens with bread and meat, and they were commanded to not be deceitful with it and hide it for tomorrow. So they were deceitful with it, and they hid it. So it was raised up in the morning. Then they were transformed into monkeys and pigs. This hadith is graded da'if, or weak. Comments. The status of al-Ma'idah, the table spread with food, whether it was descended or not, if it was descended, how big it was, and what items of food were in it, is not clear.
no authentic narration has been reported about it. Qurtubi and Ibn Kathir. Abu Huraira said, Isa was taught his argument, Allah taught him regarding his saying, and when Allah will say, O Isa, son of Maryam, did you say unto men, worship me and my mother as two gods besides Allah? Abu Huraira narrated from the Messenger of Allah, peace be upon him, so Allah taught him, glory be to you. It was not for me to say what I had no right to say. The entire ayah. This hadith is graded hasan, or good. Footnote. The verse, glory be to you, it was not for me to say what I had no right to say, is from Surat Al-Maidah, chapter 5, verse 116. Comments. This question and answer session will take place on the Day of Judgment, in the gathering full with the people, to disgrace and humiliate the Christians who regard Isa, peace be upon him, Jesus, and his mother as partners to Allah. Abdullah ibn Amr said, the last surah revealed was Surat Al-Ma'idah and Al-Fath. This hadith is graded hasan, or good. Comments. Every companion singled out a surah to be revealed last according to his own view and in the light of the signs and circumstances. No prophetic statement expressed this.